Good morning, War Eagles. My name is Thomas Costello, and I will be your anchor for today's show. And now, in memory of 9/11, here is a video summarizing the event of that fateful day.
On the morning of September 11, 2001, four planes had struck the nation. Two hit the World Trade Center in New York, one hit the Pentagon, and one crashed in Pennsylvania. One of the flights was American Airlines Flight 11, a Boeing 767 aircraft, which had departed Logan Airport at 7:59 a.m. en route to Los Angeles with a crew of 11 people and 76 passengers, not including the five hijackers. The hijackers then flew the plane into the northern facade of the North Tower of the World Trade Center at 8:46 a.m. This was the first plane. Next of which was United Airlines Flight 173, which had departed Logan Airport at 8:14 a.m. And then after taking over the plane, the hijackers then flew it into the South Tower of the World Trade Center at 9:03 a.m. This was the second plane. Then there was American Airlines Flight 77, which had taken off from Washington Jewell's Airport and was aimed at the Pentagon and crashed. This was the third plane. Now the fourth and final plane, known as Flight 93, was headed towards the White House in Washington, D.C., but the passengers heard where it was heading, and they ended up taking back the plane. Shortly after, however, it had crashed in Shanksville, Pennsylvania, at 10:03 a.m. The death total on 9/11 was 2,996, including 343 firefighters, 71 law enforcement officers, 55 military personnel, and 125 people in the Pentagon.
And now for some announcements. If you need opportunities for community service, see Coach Levering in room E114. The bowling roster is posted outside the counseling office, so if you're a bowler, go check that out. Region Students Bank Board applications are available in F216 for juniors interested in both business and leadership. And now for some clubs. The Spanish Honor Society will be having their first meeting September 21st at 7:45 in the lecture hall. Anime Club will meet Fridays at 7:50 in room F004, Miss Kitty's room. GSA will also have their meetings Wednesday at 7:50, also in Miss Kitty's room. FCA meets on Thursday mornings, 7:45 in room F009. And finally, the Keystone Club meets every Tuesday at 7:45 in room F006. Earlier this week, students marched together in support of the DACA policy. Their protests were recorded today in today's special report.
Good afternoon, Heritage High School. This is Thomas Costello for War Eagle Television. What we're seeing right now is a live footage of the beginning of the DACA march.
On September 12th, a group of students came together to organize a march promoting the reinstatement of DACA. They walked tall together in what some might call the greatest rally for change Heritage has ever seen.
It's time for the students to say how they feel and have a way to express it. I think this is a great idea.
It's a good idea. We're out here supporting the Dreamers. We're supporting DACA.
What does DACA mean to you?
Well, it means everything, man. These are, I guess you say, my people to me too, because I am Salvadorian. I'm going to support them in everything.
The march means being heard, having our voices be heard by everyone around us, not just the community, but also, you know, higher up people that have the power to change everything for us. But in the same condition, if you want to make change, it's going to take commitment. Some people
stop the hate! Stop the fear! Never let the world but here! Stop the hate! Stop the fear! Never
I've been on the mission, and I really can't take it.
After meeting together at the Frisco Station in downtown Rogers, the marchers were greeted by guest speakers that talked about how DACA shaped their lives. The speakers included coaches, community leaders, and fellow students. On September 5th, 2017, Attorney General Jeff Sessions announced a halt to the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals Act, also known as the DREAMer program. This sudden stop to a five-year-old policy was issued by President Donald Trump with the intent of reducing taxes for the United States. However, this continuing this program would affect more than 800,000 people directly. War Eagle TV was able to talk to one of our student liaisons for an in-depth interview.
DACA was an initiative that was put forth by President Obama, and it was to aid a particular demographic or population to be able to have a chance and a pathway towards citizenship. It is not naturalization, or it's not citizenship guaranteed. What happened last week is President Trump rescinded that initiative, but also too he's calling on Congress and giving them 6 months to come forward with some policies to be able to protect those that were protected under DACA, which is approximately 800,000 people in the U.S. And so it's now up to policymakers and also up to voters and individuals to influence policymakers to take a long-term challenge of the DREAM Act, which has been at least 15 years in the making.
And now here's a PSA about staying off your phone during school.
Are you on your phone during class? Well, don't be, because if you're on your phone during class, then you're distracted. When you're distracted, you fail the test. When you fail the test, you get kicked out of class. When you get kicked out of class, you drop out of school. When you drop out of school, you ignore all your friends. When you ignore all your friends, you have no one to lend you a charger. When you have no one to lend you a charger, your phone dies. When your phone dies, you have to resort to begging for memes on the street. Don't beg for memes on the street. Stay off your phone. Don't be a phony.
The Student Council had their presidential elections earlier this week. Here is Seth Curran with more details.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy Seth, Pigeon Productions. You know, we decided to do Student Council because, you know, these guys are working hard. You know, stay tuned for next week for the latest.
What role does class president play in Stuco?
As a class president, we show leadership, and we're supposed to represent our class, and we do what we think is best for them.
We organize the senior class events and everything. We try to make it fun, and we try to get the senior class more into the events we have in school.
It not only teaches you leadership, but it teaches you being able to communicate well with others and being a leader not only to yourself but to your peers and helping them out like in any way you possibly can.
A junior class president basically names the people who are nominated for homecoming and College Day Court, and we try to influence juniors to do better.
If elected president, what actions will you take?
I think I would help organize the student council better, kind of like lead the senior class more towards graduation, along with the dances, help organize the homecoming Colors Day dances.
Well, during lunch, I've noticed that people keep throwing trash on the floor, and sometimes I pick it up for them. And so what I've decided is like make like a rule that if you threw it or something, you might get detention. If you like put teachers out here so they can watch.
We don't want to leave people out. We want everyone to work together and just support each other.
You take initiative in whatever is happening around, and you're always trying to get kids around the school that are in your same class more involved and more excited about things that are happening. You want them to feel welcomed in our school.
I believe we also have a job to show the underclassmen how it's done here and how to have fun, but also be interested in our studies, show that everyone belongs here and that this is a pretty great school.
That's our show for today, War Eagles. I'm Thomas Costello. signing out. Oh. Yo. We got one more. And now for an ad about t-shirts.
Do you not like your t-shirts?
Don't know what to wear?
Do they just stink? Please do not try this at home, because then this will happen. Then buy a Heritage t-shirt.
Become one, go away. Oh.